People, welcome back to Politics Watch. Now, for all you Uber workers, I have very good news. It turns out the Jamaican government will soon be legalizing Uber. And they're doing it on the basis of that, one, the fines for Uber are so low that they're basically a waste of time. Because at the moment, the fine for practicing Uber in Jamaica is $100. So the fine is so low that it's basically a waste of time to go court and to deal with paperwork and all that for $100, right? The law was originally enacted in 1898, so obviously back then $100 was a lot of money, but it hasn't been changed since, right? But now, another reason why government is planning to repeal it is because they're looking at it from the point of view of it's a religious right, because you're denying people the right to exercise the religion they believe in, right? Now obviously this is controversial, because you know a lot of Jamaicans are very hostile when it comes down to Uber, right? So what I want people to tell me is, now that the law, I mean, it still hasn't been signed, you know, right, but it's about to be legalized. Do you think it's going to increase after it's legalized? Personally, I don't think it's going to make a difference, because people have been practicing whether it's legal or illegal, right? I think real Uber people don't care about the law, right? So people are still going to link them Uber man, right? But I need to know what you people think about this. What do you think about it from the religious point of view? Because remember, even though the act of Uber is demonizing Jamaica, it really is an African tradition. It started in Africa, right? And it, for some, it's a system of spirituality and healing, right? So do you think turning your back on Uber is turning our back on African culture? Have you ever looked at it from that angle? It's very interesting. I mean, from the day I was born, I've always heard people talk about Uber as if, you know, it's something bad. But then when I look at the history of it, it's actually coming from Africa, and it came with the slaves, and people used it during slavery, and they use it to this day. And a lot of people, even some people who would surprise you, you know, actually believe in it strongly. Right, especially Badman. Badman love Uber man. Tell it who love Uber man. Badman, police, people like that love Uber man. So all you people out there who have your Uber man link and you have to hide, and you don't have to hide anymore, soon the laws are going to change, and soon it will be legal for people to freely practice necromancy, right? I mean, it's a funny story. I find it funny, but for some people, it's life and death, you know. But, and even if, you know, when you look at countries like Haiti, in Haiti, it's normalized. It's a normal thing. It's like church, right? It's a way of life, because as you know, Haiti is still, the African culture is still very strong in Haiti. Very strong. So for them it's something normal, but in Jamaica obviously it's not, and it still has this stigma attached to it. But a lot of people to this day now they for them science man, not at all. If something wrong with them, the first people them go check at them science man. It's just the reality of the situation. The people, let me know in the comment section what they think. Do you think it should be legalized, or do you think the government would keep it legal and increase the fine from $100 to something higher, like, for example, I don't know, $100,000. Let me know in the comment section.